It's the hot seat. Today I'd like to introduce you to a very special guest. I really do consider him as one of the best British Asian talents out there. He's already been nominated as the UK AMA Best Newcomer and he's already done a little bit of music for Bollywood. I'd like to introduce you to a very good friend of mine, Navin Kundra.
Good, I'm good. How are you?
Good. Good to see you.
I know. Good to see you too.
And welcome to the Star Wars hot seat. How are you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm all right. It's good to see you up in here. Usually when I'm seeing you, I have to say it's on stage at one of the Mellors.
Yeah.
How have the Mellors been for you, man?
They've been great. Just finished a whole summer of Mellors. Uh-huh. Fantastic response. Great to see thousands of people out there. Really good vibe.
Is that one of the things as an artist that you've always wanted? Is to play in front of a live crowd and just
absolutely
get that crowd reaction.
Yeah, I mean, they're some of the biggest audiences that you can play to, so is that, I think it's a dream for every artist to be up there and to see guys singing along to your songs. It's a fantastic feeling.
That must really give you some serious vibes, though.
Yeah, for sure.
Seeing people, you know, just listening to them singing along, there must be points where you actually stop singing.
Yeah,
and you just let them sing along.
Yeah.
How does that make you feel?
It's great. I mean, I remember the first time. It was quite an emotional experience, actually, the first time that happened, especially with the song Dirili.
Oh, wow.
And they kind of sing it back to me. It's an indescribable feeling.
Because that's a love song as well. And you usually expect, you know, the younger Asians, when they're at a mele, they want the really up-tempo stuff.
Yeah.
And that's a serious love song, isn't
yeah.
it?
Yeah.
And did you ever think that, you know, doing slow jams like that would get your music recognised as much as it did?
See, the thing is, everyone said in this market, uh-huh. especially in the UK Asian market, you have to do club tracks, they all have to be up-tempo. Mm-hmm. And my whole take on music is that it doesn't have to be that, it just has to connect with people.
Mm.
And Dirilia did that. And the ballad, I mean, we've had some great chart success, kind of number one for the last 12 weeks across the UK, which has been great.
So Navin, tell us how you started off in the music industry. How old were you and how did it all start off for you?
With singing and kind of music, it was literally an audition that started it all off. I went along to, I think it was a Wembley Mellor or something. Mm-hmm. And we went there not thinking there was going to be any auditions, just a day out with the family. And they had auditions for the shows like the Asian X Factor.
Right.
And I remember them saying, I'll go and try it out. So I was like, okay, I'll go along. And I sang. And they called me back for a second audition. And then they called me back for a third audition. And then I remember sort of, it was 4 o'clock one morning and I get this phone call from Bombay. And this guy, he says, Navin. And I was like, you know, when you wake up in the morning, 4 o'clock in the morning, you're croaky and you're like, you're not even awake. I was like, yeah, hello. And he's like, Ganaga. And I was like, you know, who is this guy? I was like, who are you? And do you know what time it is? Because they're 5 hours ahead, right? So he kind of asked me to sing down the phone and I'm calling you from Bombay mm-hmm. and I need you to sing for me. So at that point I was like, oh, I better wake up, kind of, and I remember singing that song. Har ghadi badal rahi hai roop zindagi. And after I sang that, he said, okay, you're coming to Dubai, you're going to represent the UK in the World Series.
Hold on, this was just from you going to a mellor.
Yeah, that's
where
right.
Where I now see you perform.
Yeah.
And were you even a singer? Were you even thinking about being a singer at the time?
Not really, I mean, I kind of had a passion for singing and music, but I didn't expect it to lead to that. And it was a fantastic experience, you know, being on stage performing with Shan, one of my favorite Bollywood playback singers, judged by Ghulam Ali Ji, Jagjit Singh Ji, Zakir Hussain Saab. It really kind of introduced me into the whole Asian music industry.
And from there, you just decided that this is what I want to do. This I do want to become a singer.
Absolutely.
And your family are supportive with the
whole
thing?
Very supportive, very supportive. I mean, I have a degree and everything as well. So I've completed all my education, and I think they were quite adamant about that I do that. But they've been very supportive because they know it makes me happy, and you know, I couldn't really do it without them.
Did some playback stuff for Bollywood. Can you tell me how that came about?
Yeah, that actually came about through through Rishi Rich,
okay,
who I first met actually. He was a judge on another talent competition which I entered.
You've done quite a few talent shows by the looks of it.
Yeah, they're not the most enjoyable thing to do, but I think it's a great way of kind of exposing talent. Okay. You need, every artist needs a platform on which to showcase what they can do. And Rishi Rich was one of the judges. We kind of stayed in touch, and he flew Anu Malik over to do some work on a Bollywood soundtrack, played him some of my stuff, and Anu really liked what he heard, and he said, you know, this guy sings in English, Hindi and Punjabi, let's get him in, and, you know, I want to get him to vocal the track.
So Anu Malik had already heard of the stuff that you've done prior to you meeting him?
Yeah, that's right.
Wow.
That's right. It was good.
See, you've actually achieved quite a bit, and you know, you've not even been in the scene for that long, really, have you?
Mm. Yeah, thank you, man.
You're one of the people one of the few people, I should say, that can sing and play an instrument together. So when you walked in with that guitar,
I was
actually overwhelmed seeing you bring that in. Would you mind playing us a little something?
Sure, man. For you, anything.
One of your hits, because I know you've had loads of radio hits. So.
Yeah.
What are you going to do for us? Wow.
That's it. Shall I put it down?
I mean, I've already had the chills up my spine.
Okay. I'll break a track down acoustically off my album. It's called...
Do you want me to participate in...
Love Thing. Can you beatbox?
No.
Can you rap?
No.
Sing?
No.
Maybe?
No.
Okay, you just enjoy it.
Sounds better.
ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਤੂੰ ਇਸ਼ਾਰੇ ਕਰ ਦੇ ਲੱਕ ਨੂੰ ਹਿਲਾ ਕੇ ਮੇਰੀ ਜਾਨ ਕੱਢ ਦੇ ਜਾਂਜਰਾਂ ਦੇ ਬੋਲ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਕੋਲ ਸੱਦ ਦੇ ਦਿਲ ਸਾਡਾ ਤੂੰ ਲੁੱਟਿਆ ਉਹ ਕੁੜੀਏ ਸਖੀਆਂ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਤੂੰ ਕਿੰਨੀ ਹੱਸਦੀ ਦਿਲ ਵਾਂਗੂ ਮੇਰੇ ਸੀਨੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਵੱਸਦੀ ਜਿਵੇਂ ਜ਼ੁਲਫਾਂ ਘੁਮਾ ਕੇ ਮੇਰਾ ਦਿਲ ਠੱਗਦੀ ਦਿਲ ਸਾਡਾ ਤੂੰ ਲੁੱਟਿਆ ਮੁੰਡਿਆਂ ਦੀ ਤੇਰੇ ਉੱਤੇ ਆਖਣੀ ਨੱਚ ਲੈ ਸੋਣੀਏ ਮੁੰਡਿਆਂ ਦੀ ਤੇਰੇ ਉੱਤੇ ਆਖਣੀ ਨੱਚ ਲੈ ਸੋਣੀਏ Could be a loving.
Navin, that was amazing.
Thank you, bro.
On that note, ladies and gents, we're going to be back on the other side, and hopefully we could keep Navin around and get him to sing us one more track. So don't touch that remote control.